people of God, as we are learning and growing in the things of God, listen to me. If the enemy has stolen anything from you, the only way for you to get it back is you got to fight. The Bible says very clearly, since the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violent take it by force. So you got to get back what the enemy has stolen from you and your loved ones, and you've got to make sure that you release generational blessings over your family line. So in 2 Kings chapter 5, I brought you here to give you a live example of what we've been teaching thus far. We've been telling you about the root causes and about how things are happening in the lives of God's people and why they're happening. And sometimes you just need to see it in the word of what's going on. I know you have your own life and you have your own scenarios, but what better way to see an actual example of what can happen in the word of God by decisions that we make as people? Know this, we taught something long time ago about the man who was born blind. Remember when they went to Jesus and they said, well, Jesus, who sinned? That him or his parents? And Jesus said, nobody sinned. This is because of the glory of, for the glory of God. See, if Jesus, if they were wrong in asking him who sinned because this boy was made blind, Jesus would have said, there's no way that he could be made blind behind somebody else's sin, whether it's his sin or his parents' sin. Jesus would have said, that's ludicrous. Stop thinking that way, disciples. But no, he did not. What he said was not neither him nor his parents sinned. He said, but this is for the glory of God, which means there is a possibility that you and I as parents, our parents, their parents, and parents on and on and on back 10 generations, they could have done certain things, sinful things, that would have opened you up to a curse, to a dark side, to something that will cause you to lose. So look at this example here in 2 Kings chapter 5. I'm going to read two verses, explain it a little bit more, and we're going to get out of here. 2 Kings, let's look at verses 26 and 27. Matter of fact, I'm going to read a little bit more for the sake of understanding. All right, so here we go. This is the thing where Gehazi is the student of Elisha. So he is the mentee, and Elisha is the mentor. And so he's working with Elisha, and Elisha has given him some instructions of what he should do, because they're right now dealing with a person who needs a blessing. And so Elisha wants to bless the person, but Elisha doesn't want to get anything in return. But Gehazi has a different agenda. Look where we're going to pick up here. It goes in verse 20. But Gehazi, the servant of Elisha, the man of God, said, look, my master has spared Naaman, this Syrian, while not receiving from his hand. I'm sorry, this is Naaman. But while not receiving from his hands what he brought. But as the Lord lives, I will run after him and take something from him. I'm sorry, this is the story where Naaman, the leopard, was actually being told by Elisha to go dip in the water. And Elisha, Naaman wanted Elisha to come to him. And Elisha just gave the word and said, go dip seven times. But Gehazi is trying to actually capture or benefit from it in a financial way. Look at verse 21. So Gehazi pursued Naaman. When Naaman saw him running after him, he got down from the chariot to meet him and said, is all well? And he said, all is well. My master has sent me, saying, indeed, just now, two young men of the sons of the prophets have come to me from the mountains of Ephraim. Please give them a talent of silver and two changes of garments. So Naaman said, please take two talents. And he urged him and bound two talents of silver in two bags with two changes of garments and handed them to two of his servants, and they carried them on ahead of him. When he came to the citadel and stored them away in the house, then he let the men go, and they departed. Now he went in, and this is where I wanted to be. And now he went in and stood before his master Elisha, saying to him, where did you go, Gehazi? And he said, your servant did not go anywhere. Then he said to him, did not my heart go with you when the man turned back from his chariot to meet you? Is it time to receive money and to receive clothing, olive groves and vine and vineyards, sheep and oxen, male and female servants? Therefore, this is the word. Y'all, I want you to see this. Therefore, the leprosy of Naaman shall cling to you and your descendants forever. And he went out from his presence leprous, as white as snow. Do you see? Gehazi made a decision, people of God, that he wanted to get paid for the work of God that Elisha had done in Naaman's life. He wanted to get money. He wanted to get gold and silver. He wanted to get all kinds of things because he was one for hire. He was one that wanted the money more than what he was supposed to do, which was be obedient. And so Elisha, being a man of God, knew what Gehazi had done. He gave Gehazi a moment to repent and to say, yes, I did go after Naaman. I got this from him, and I'm bringing it to you. Even though he knew it was not even for him, at least he could have given himself a chance to be forgiven. But yet he lied, and he told Elisha, I didn't go anywhere. My point is this. Elisha now puts a curse on Gehazi. But he doesn't just put a curse on Gehazi. He puts a curse on Gehazi and all of his descendants. Do you know anybody in the bloodline of Gehazi will be leprous? Do you know their skin condition will never be rectified by a prescription from a doctor? Do you know they can't go to the nurse, the doctor, they can't go to the best hospitals around the world to receive a healing? Because this disease, this leprosy, did not begin in the natural. It is a spiritual thing that has happened to Gehazi, and everybody in Gehazi's bloodline will be leprous. Because what does it say? I'm not making it up. You see it right there in verse 27. It says, therefore, the leprosy of Naaman shall cling to you and your descendants. How long?
Forever.
Forever. That's the prophet of God. The man of God, Elisha, has now summoned Gehazi and his descendants to leprosy forever. Don't you know there are some things that have been spoken over the lives of your family members just like this? You don't know, I don't know for sure. That is why we are saying to you, open up your spiritual eyes and get down to the root of your problem. Because guess what? Some of us have been dealing with the same stuff for all of our lives. And now God is saying, I'm bringing you the answer. Take some time. Sit yourself down. Write down what's happening in your life. And then you need to be determined to find out, what's the root of that? Where did it come from? Because guess what? Now, there is hope in this. Hear me. There is hope in this for Gehazi's descendants. The only hope there is if they understand the power in the name of Jesus. The only hope there is if they understand the word, the power in the blood of Jesus. The only hope there is if they can understand what causes their skin to be leprous. If they never get an indication that they are sick, broke, busted, disgusted, just totally destroyed and distraught, can't ever go forward, can't ever be blessed, can't ever receive a breakthrough, if they never understand that this curse came from grandpa, great-grandpa, great-great-great-great-grandpa, daddy, whatever he is in your life, if you don't understand that Gehazi has opened the door for his family line to be cursed with leprosy from Naaman forever, then you'll never be free. That's why it's good to know. Hear this. This is where the hope is. It's good to know the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit's job is to do what? Tell you and remind you of things. The Holy Spirit's job is to do what? Lead you into all truth. So no fear, no being frenzied or being in a frenzy. Don't have to worry about, oh, I don't know, maybe this happened. Maybe, no, no, you don't have to put your mind in it. Keep your mind out of it. But this is what you need to do. In order to find out what has transpired, you must recognize that there are and there is a Holy Spirit that's available to us. So you want to cleanse yourself as you did this morning from anything that will block you from truth, that will block you from hearing from God, that will block you from getting revelation about your life. And that way, if your skin is leprous, and listen, I'm saying your skin being leprous, but it could be anything. Leprosy is in the bloodline. So it can actually manifest any kind of way. It may not be your skin. It may be your pocket. It may be your marriage. It may be your finances. It may be your career. It may be your education, your business. It just may be your lifestyle. Anything can bring you to this place. Gehazi did this to his family. He had excessive love for money. He had excessive love for material things. And this is what caused the curse to come on his children. So what should we do? We must first remember that Jesus says to seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all these things shall be added unto us. Matthew 6:33. And then we must maintain consistent, holy living, personal fellowship with God, hearing him speak to us, hearing him speak to us and calling us by name. This will cause us to reflect in the unity that we have with him. And then God will reveal the root of the problems in your life. Gehazi's children will automatically be leprous. And this skin sore cannot be cured by medicines. To achieve a permanent solution, hear this. The power of that curse must be broken in that particular person's life. And this will result in a cure from the disease of leprosy. So this is what you have to do, Bread of Life, Facebook, stream, conference. This is what you have to do. You have to remember what Galatians say. Galatians 3:13, that Jesus became a curse for all of us. For cursed is everyone who hang it upon a tree. You know, we've been redeemed from the curse. When you know that you've been redeemed from the curse, now you use the blood of Jesus and you say, I break the curse of leprosy. I'm using that because that's what the text says, but whatever yours is. I break the curse of leprosy by the power in the blood of Jesus. I break the curse and I command you now to leave my life in the name and through the power that's in the blood. As you break this curse, that's when this thing is going to be uprooted from your foundation. And that's when you're going to have a lasting solution of being delivered from that family curse. People of God, I can't say any more today. I'm going to stop there. But I have more to tell you about this. But there may be some Gehazi in your life. You may even be the Gehazi. Maybe you were doing the wrong thing. And the Bible is clear that God says he will visit the iniquity of the fathers who hate him on the third and the fourth generations. People of God, don't take this lightly. This root can certainly be, evil root causes can be uprooted. And when they are uprooted, then and only then will you have a lasting solution. Father God, we bless and we thank you today for the truth of your word. We thank you, Lord God, that you are present and wanting to help us. God, we ask now that you would open up our eyes to show us any Gehazi-like situations in our bloodline. Father, today let your people be wise. Let us have revelation, and we ask you, Holy Spirit, to lead us into all truth. We ask now that you would show us the cause of the trouble in our lives. Show us what the root cause is, Father, and help us to be set totally free in the name of Jesus. And God, we bless and we praise you for the blood, that the blood of Jesus gives us the authority to break every curse and to destroy every evil covenant in the name and through the power that's in the blood. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Hallelujah and amen. Come on and bless the Lord, people of God. I rushed through that. I know I'm sorry, but it is late. I don't even know what time it is. But anyway, I know it's been here. I've been here for a little bit. So we bless and we thank God for each and every one of you. Anyone have a question, comments, concerns before we go? All right, well, we're going to sign off today. I want you to know that you're welcome to fellowship with us on Tuesdays as we have our prayer. We do it only by conference line. You want the number, you know, hit us up on Facebook or stream or whatever. If you want the information to call in for prayer, prayer starts at 8 p.m. Eastern Time, 7 Central. We also have our Word Explosion on Wednesdays where I'm going to continue teaching about Gehazi and teaching more about the root causes and how we can use certain weapons. People of God, it's about to get real, real good up in here in the name of Jesus. But I love you all. We thank God for you. And on behalf of Vern and myself, we are grateful that you have fellowship with us. May your day be blessed. May your week be sweet. May the Lord bless you in your coming and your going. May he fight for you. May the horn and the sound of the shofar scatter your enemies. May this year of Jubilee bring blessings because it's about to close in October. So may the blessings of Jubilee run you down and take you over. And may the new year of God on his biblical calendar bring you blessings and promises that you have never, ever been able to fulfill. Bring those manifestations in your life in Jesus' mighty name. And now may the Lord bless you. And may the Lord keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. And may the Lord lift his countenance upon you and grant you peace, prosperity, joy unspeakable, and full of glory. It's in the name and through the power that's in the blood. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. And for anyone on Facebook, if you have written any questions or anything, I will comment on those later. But we love you all. Be blessed and enjoy the rest of your day. And we're going to sign off here as we play our last song. You know, we always fellowship after. So we're going to play our last song. But you are blessed and ready to enjoy the rest of your week in Jesus' mighty name. Glory to God. Enjoy your day, people of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I want a different song. Where am I? Oh, here it is.
Presence of the Lord, see the Lord. Presence of the Lord, see the Lord. Presence of the Lord, see the Lord. Spirit of the Lord is here. Spirit of the Lord is here. I feel it.